Arnab, let me affirm something. Arnab, I stand very strongly for secular and liberal values for that very reason. This is the garb Tarun, and Tarun is not the only journalist in this town who's used this garb to play partisan Congress politics over the last 5 or 6 years. And now he's using that same garb to defend a personal affront, a crime, an act that is today rightly being labeled as rape. We must stand up and say that this has nothing to do with secularism or liberalism. This is absolute misuse of terms which are important to cover up a crime for which Tarun has no other defense. How can we not link these two? How do we not take a stand on these two? I do not understand the point Namita is trying to make. How can you not take a position and say that Tarun and people like him take up the name of secularism and liberalism in these sham ways? Let me finish, Namita. I did not interfere when you were speaking. That under this sham guise to cover up crime of the most heinous nature, that is an affront to all of us.
Oh, yes. Well said. Well said. And Rahul wanted to, Rahul Singh wanted to come in. By the way,
I'm appalled at the self-righteousness being displayed during this.
What? Who's showing the self-righteousness, Namita? Sorry, I didn't get you there.
Who's self-righteousness?
Who's being self-righteous?
Too many people.
Who?
Anyone defending?
Who? I don't believe in talking in generalities. Be specific.
Serious issue.
Absolutely.
Who? You see, the problem is, Namita, there is a certain section again which does not want to get specific on this subject. You know, they don't want to specifically talk about the contradictions of what Tarun has said.
How can one?
Why can't we? Why shouldn't we? Why should we generalize?
Tarun is trying to defend himself in the most absurd fashion, and that is his right. And I think that people need to start focusing
well,
on the real
issues. That is, if
this
that is
really
his right,
not about
if
whether that, the Congress
and don't we have
him.
A right to say anything about it?
Well, come on, Namita. You know, all those people who make all these long speeches about what feminist politics and misogyny and etc., violence against women, they all want to make this some philosophical discussion on feminism and violence against women and sexual politics, when the fact of the matter is they should be getting specific in, on the issue of Tarun Tejpal. And I think it helps the case of Tarun Tejpal, if I may say so, if certain people, and I hope that you are not part of it, Namita, who want to overgeneralize on the subject too, in order to put a sheath over the lies that are being expressed at this point of time. And you know that this is on the News Hour, and on the News Hour, at least I don't allow those broad theoretical, broad brush generalizations that happen on some other channels. I think Rajesh Kalra wanted to come in. Rajesh, let's get specific tonight. What are the mistakes in between what Tarun is saying now and what he said earlier?
See, the first letter where he actually, you know, where when this girl has written to Tarun and she says that he actually screamed at me, how dare you go and discuss this incident with my daughter? Don't you know the relationship between the father and daughter?
Yeah.
Now, this is completely bizarre, you know. Actually, he's showing as if only one's daughters are to be protected. Anybody else's daughter is fair game. I think that is the thing which comes out when he says that. And I think it is absolutely absurd. And I also don't understand this entire thing about Goa and getting it out of Goa because it's BJP run and all. You are almost casting aspersions on the process of law which takes place. You know, it is actually just not fair.
Yeah, I agree with you. Yes, Rahul. Rahul Singh.
Can I have a word?
Yes, Rahul Singh. Go ahead.
Yeah, please. You know, you had I've appeared on your program about 3 times, and initially you had told me that I was politicizing the issue. Now most of your panelists are doing exactly that. Please remember that we are in an election.
No, no, 1 second. By the way, the only person politicizing it is Tarun Tejpal.
No, we are not politicizing.
Who's politicizing?
The application?
No, no. One second. Pinky Anand's responding to you. First of all, let's get a rebut on that.
Anyway,
Pinky Anand is responding to you. Yes,
Pinky. Finish that.
I don't see where any political element in this issue comes in. This is a general issue which is affecting all of society. You have a complaint which the girl has made, which comes out in the open, and thanks to the media, which also helps this entire process. And but for these issues, maybe these kind of sexual assaults may go unnoticed and unreported. The report comes out. Mr. Tarun Tejpal himself admits the fact that he has done something wrong and apologizes for it. And then there is this entire atonement and philosophical theory. The scene then becomes where where the state itself, finding a report and a complaint of rape, registers an FIR, which the Supreme Court in Lalita Kumar and all these cases says, you have to do it. You have no choice. It's a cognizable offence. You are bound to do it. The police does it. The investigation starts. And at that point, suddenly the secular fabric and the idea of saying that Goa is manifested with BJP motives and therefore this action is happening. I mean, where is this entire thing going? Are we talking about an offence that has taken place or not?
I will give an opportunity. Oh, no, one second. Let's give an opportunity for Mr. Thug, Rahul Singh, to correct himself. Because once again, Mr. Rahul Singh got it completely wrong in his opening remarks because he knows the person who made it political was Tarun Tejpal. And he did so in his statement in a writ petition before the Delhi High Court this morning.
I'm not defending Tarun in all this. All I want to make a certain point is Rahul. We are making a hate.
Rahul, in a bail application, you don't talk about secular fabric. In a bail application, you talk about what you've done vis-a-vis the offence or not done the offence or the mitigating circumstances. That is what a bail application is about. I mean, we don't go talking about secular fabric and being behind secular fabrics.
We are creating a hate figure. That's what we're doing. The media is coming into focus here. I've been talking to a lot of people on this issue and they want to pick on somebody in the media.
Are you saying that Tarun is,
this is all
Tarun
that's wrong
is not
with
there
the media.
Or not liable?
No, who's the media? Who's the media? Rahul Singh, is the girl not in the media?
Targeted anybody who does wrong.
I don't understand this, Mr. Rahul Singh. I've never heard a more absurd argument. I am asking you this. In his letter on, have you lost all sense of balance in this debate, Mr. Rahul Singh? Do you remember that Tarun Tejpal, your friend Tarun Tejpal, in his own admission, in his own letter to the victim, said, and I quote, I attempted a sexual liaison with you on two occasions on November 7th and 8th, despite your clear reluctance that you did not want such attention from me. You understand? He said that. Now, he goes and says before the court, on 8th, only 1 minute, Mr. Rahul Singh, you don't want to hear what's going to embarrass you? Mr. Rahul Singh? He says, now a further meeting took place between two individuals. You tell me, when a person tries to force himself on someone in the form of a sexual liaison, can he describe that as a further meeting? Is that a meeting? An attempt to rape is a meeting.
I'm not defending him.
No, then of course you are defending him. You said the media is coming into focus and we are creating a hate figure.
And I think, Arnab, you need to even go further to ask, where is a secular issue in this? Where is the secular issue in this? I don't understand.
No, we will discuss that. But I want to know if anyone on the program tonight has actually gone into details of what Tarun Tejpal's letter says. When he writes to Shoma Chaudhary confessing. At his submission before the court.
That is an admission for all purposes, Arnab. That is an admission for all purposes, Arnab. In fact, one of his weakest links is his own admission.
In fact, the two letters that he has written,
yes, Rajesh,
are nothing but an admission that he did commit the crime, except that the girl disagreed with him and said it was not a sexual lesion but a molestation. She corrected him in her resignation letter.
Yeah. And here's the question. You know, we are being asked here tonight that you're creating a hate figure and Namita Devidayal wants to overgeneralize on the subject. I'd like to ask you, Namita. He says, Tarun Tejpal says now, the alleged colleague referred above continued to party and was completely normal and friendly all throughout her stay in Goa. She went to the Remo Fernandez function, which began around 7:30 and lasted into late evening. So, what is he trying to say, Namita? The victim is supposed to lock herself up, shut herself in, you know, curl up and die. Victims of rape do not have the right to lead a normal life.
Comment on what he said. He's
what? You are aware of what he said?
This is something that has to take the due course of law.
Why are you?
It has to take the due course of law. All the various documentary evidence, the text messages, calls, the letters,
Namita, interviews. Namita, why are you being so cagey?
Due course of law, you have
taking
to.
One second. Again, you are being so cagey. I wonder whether if it had been a case of Asaram, you would have been so cagey. But in this case, you are so completely cagey. You are being so careful. Because it's Tarun Tejpal, Namita, let's be clear about it. One second. Shivam is contradicting you. Shivam.
What is the behavior after episode is of no consequence.
Precisely.
The question is, if the offense has happened, it has happened. She may have decided to lock herself in or go outside and or go to remote program. That is neither.
No, what is this Bollywood imagination of the hapless rape victim who will be crying and breaking up bangles you know, there can be trauma, there can be anger. Absolutely. She also writes in a letter that she had to think about saving her job. She was supposed to be, by way of her job, meant to be at those conferences, those Remo Fernandez concert or whatever it was. She was given the non-journalistic duty of chaperoning people. So she was just thinking of saving her job, and Mr. Tarun Tejpal took advantage of that and molested her again the next day.
And look at the audacity of the lies.
Just because the victim is not hapless, it doesn't mean she doesn't
have and Namita, I am appalled. I am appalled tonight.
That's how it should be.
I am appalled tonight. I am so appalled. I'll be direct. I'm so appalled tonight that on a subject where there is black and white, right and wrong, crime and punishment should be discussed.
Shut, you know.
But instead of being direct, even someone like you. Yeah. Is going ahead with this whole argument, let the law take its course, let the law take its course. Kiran Bedi, let me come back to
because
you.
Some people have their friendships to
of course.
I have very unequivocal views about
well, I don't know if you have unequivocal views. Let me tell you, you're not expressing them for the last half an hour on the News Hour debate tonight. This is what Tarun Tejpal said in his letter to the victim, Kiran Bedi.
Small point about
Kiran Bedi. No, let's go back. Kiran Bedi, have you ever...
As a journalist, I know that you have to present facts in some context and present them in a way where
what context are you talking about?
It cannot be to
no,
the
what context are you
journalist Arnab
you what context are you talking Hartosh yes Hartosh
Arnab as
Arnab,
a journalist today
in?
We've
Arnab.
Seen a bail petition that slanders and maligns a girl deliberately after admission of guilt by the person concerned. As a journalist, we are not supposed
Absolutely.
To say anything about this when we know that a falsehood is being uttered, an attempt is being made to slander the character, and this is in keeping with the worst forms of defense that perpetrators of sexual offenses across the world take. And we are supposed to stay silent and let the law take its due
Absolutely.
Course. What kind of nonsense is this?
And Namita, not that I am picking on you, but
no,
but unfortunately
we're not expected to stay silent on this.
Unfortunately, Namita. Unfortunately,
I have real
Namita,
issues with the kind of slander.
No, but Namita, this is not just about the
Who
kind
slander?
Of slander. It's the slander from Tarun Tejpal. Tarun Tejpal is saying on the one side, let me go to Kiran Bedi. Tarun Tejpal writes one day, and look at this words, the way he writes, he writes very well. He says in his letter of apology to her, he says, I understand the extreme distress you have been feeling. And if regret could turn time back, the force of mind would surely place us all back in a space and time before this terrible lapse. Wonderful. Booker Prize winning English. And now you forget all that, Kiran Bedi.
Now, how do you explain that?
Now you forget all that, Kiran Bedi, and now you say the girl was partying, I had a meeting with her, she's lying, and all of this never happened. Have you in your entire career as a police officer or activist come across such a case, Kiran Bedi?
Arnav, do you know this is inadmissible evidence under the law? Because this is an admission before not a police officer. This is an admission by his own self to another person. This is a confession, an admission admissible by law. Such an admission, if he had made before a police officer, would not have been admissible. But this is an amazing admission, which he's made before a private citizen through electronic mail. Therefore, it will have very high evidentiary value in the court. Therefore, I'm very happy with this admission. He cannot get
Fantastic.
Away from it. And therefore, the man is in a soup. The man is in a soup. He's drowning. He's clutching on to anything he can. And he's now clutching on to as making it as a political issue. And also demeaning the girl. But the man is caught. He's drowning. He's been at his worst. He will continue to go worse. I can tell you he'll only go worse. Because had he been anything better, he would not have committed this act.
Which is...
But thank God, nature made him admit.
I am... No, but he may have admitted, by his own admission to the victim, he has already admitted that I have tried to carry out a sexual liaison. But my question is more fundamental and basic. Where are the people, Ami Agnik, who come out on the streets on these issues? I am asking you tonight, if suppose this had not been Tarun Tejpal, but somebody from your rival political party who had done something like this, would six leaders from your party not have had a Sunday press conference? I'm equally asking tonight, You know, it's from laceration to slander, this case is going on. Yes, it almost appears, Ami Yagnik, we have to coax you and your party to take a strident position in this case. And you know what is being spoken about. It is being said that Tarun Tejpal has strong Congress links, has had a pro-Congress line in the past. Can you not separate your ethics and your morality from your politics? Arnab,